Some of you commented on our cat names, so I thought I'd share a few more. This is Wiz Khalifa. This is Hamboy. Crunchwrap Supreme. Baby Spice. Audio 2000. Cinnamon Daddy. Harry Potter. Big Thunder. Christian Dior. And Tony Hawk, because of the obvious resemblance. I have to tell you the story of MK and Georgie, because these two cats are very closely bonded. They think that they're mother and daughter, but biologically they're not. And the story of how that happened is a weird one. When we met MK, she was very pregnant. She was the last cat in our colony to get spayed. We had tried to trap her so she could have her babies indoors, but she was too smart for our traps. Plus, she was feral, totally unsocialized to humans. So being indoors could actually be more stressful for her. So we set up some safe outdoor spots for her in case she gave birth outside. And that's what happened. Except she didn't choose any of our comfy spots and her timing wasn't great. MK gave birth in our neighbor's yard, during the one period of time when I wasn't home. I'm always home, but I wasn't home when this happened. MK had just one surviving kitten, and our neighbor found it before I got home. He didn't know it was MK's, he didn't know what to do, and it was a chilly morning, so he scooped that kitten up and he brought it inside. This was totally well-intentioned. He wanted to save the kitten. But what he didn't know is that MK was outside searching for her baby. She couldn't figure out what had happened to it. When I got home, MK was frantic. She was running around the yard, howling, searching everywhere, and she couldn't find her baby. Instead, she found Georgie. Georgie's the youngest and smallest cat in our colony, but she is an adult cat. MK's maternal wires had gotten crossed. She suddenly decided that full-grown, adult cat Georgie was her newborn infant kitten. Georgie could have protested this, but she didn't. She just kind of accepted it and was like, yeah, I'm a newborn baby. Next thing we knew, she was nursing from MK. We did get the kitten back from the neighbor and tried to reunite him with MK. But I'll have to tell you that part in part two. Here's part two. We brought MK's kitten back to her, and at first she seemed curious, like maybe she recognized him. But after a few sniffs, she wasn't convinced. The kitten didn't smell right anymore. Usually, when a kitten cries, Mama Cat will run right toward it. But every time the kitten cried, MK just ran to Georgie. MK rejected her kitten, but don't worry. He was taken in by a foster with a nursing Mama Cat, and his adopted mom took right to him. We trapped MK to get her spayed. Her belly was shaved for her spay surgery, but she was also still nursing Georgie, so she looked like this. Titties out. All the time. Georgie, who again is a fully grown adult cat and not MK's biological kitten, continued to nurse. We learned later that Georgie had been rejected from her mom and stopped nursing too early as a kitten, so maybe she needed the extra maternal love. Georgie also did normal cat things like climbing trees and running around. This baffled and annoyed MK, who couldn't understand how her newborn kitten was doing these things. For months, Georgie ran around being a cat and MK chased after her, trying to protect her. These days, MK has accepted that Georgie's now grown up, and she's not as weird and protective around her. They're still closely bonded, always together. They even play and wrestle each other now. It started out as a pretty weird situation, but MK and Georgie seemed to find each other when they both needed someone to love. I've gotten this question a lot. Have Lola and Sad Boy ever had kittens together? I want to warn you that the answer is a sad one. If you need to keep scrolling, I understand. But I do want to share the answer. Sad Boy and Lola had one litter of kittens together that we know of. This is the only video I have of them from the very first time I ever saw Lola. She was in our neighbor's yard and she had three kittens with her. All three were flame points, like Sad Boy, and I named them Possum, Potato, and Sad Boy Jr. There's one of them up on the roof, like his dad. Unfortunately, that was the only time we saw the kittens. All three died shortly after that. Some kind of predator got them. That was really heartbreaking, but it's also the reality of what life can be like for feral cats, and it's why we focus so much energy now on spaying and neutering. We love kittens, but shelters are already full of them, and the ones born on the streets often don't have happy endings. After that, Lola was spayed, Sad Boy was neutered, and now they live out their retirement here with no more kittens and no more hardships. How old is Sad Boy? Usually when people ask this, I just say that he's as old as the earth itself, which honestly is kind of the best answer I can give you. We've known Sad Boy for about a year now, but he lived here for many, many years before I moved in, so we really have no idea when he was born or how long he's been around. At his most recent vet visit, they did note that his teeth are ancient. He could easily be at least 10 years old. That's just an estimate, but he's definitely an old cat, especially for a feral guy. Indoor cats can live 10 to 15 years, but the average lifespan of a feral cat is much shorter. It varies a lot, but we're talking closer to 2 to 5 years, if that. Sad Boy is truly elderly in terms of street cats. That makes me think he probably had someone looking out for him at some point, but when we met him, he didn't have any humans on his side. Now he's got all of you. This is Francois. He is the dumbest cat I have ever met. And I say that with love, but I have seen this cat walk straight into a brick wall and then get scared of the sound his head made when it hit the wall. There's just not a lot going on behind those eyes. Francois is a flame point Siamese. He's basically like a little toasted marshmallow who lives in my yard. He was pretty feral when we found him. He wasn't socialized to humans at all. This is what he looked like before he was neutered. But he's gotten much better. Now he's just kind of like a goofy little dummy. I still can't touch him. He does not allow pets. But that's okay. He's got boundaries. We respect a man with boundaries. He actually has a sister named Alien. And a brother named Mr. Business. And they've both been adopted already. Francois has this kind of like long neck thing going on. He looks kind of like a weasel. Sometimes. Here he is trick-or-treating. His one true love in life is Temptations' crunchy cat treats. I can basically summon him out of thin air anytime if treats are involved. He's just kind of a weird little marshmallow man, and he's living his best life here. Some of you have asked what kind of cat Francois is, since he's such a perfectly toasted marshmallow with stunning blue eyes. Francois is a flame point Siamese, and here's a fun fact for you. Flame points are essentially albino orange tabbies. You can see the orange coming through on his toasty little face and his stripy little tail, but on the rest of his body, that orange color is repressed, so he ends up kind of a creamy white color. Sad Boy is Francois's dad, and also a flame point. From a distance, he looks like just a white cat, but close up, you can see some orange on his tail and face. And he's usually squinting, but he actually does have bright blue eyes. Another fun fact is that that color point gene is temperature sensitive. So when you think of a typical Siamese cat, it's the warmest parts of the body, like the torso, that are light colored, and the colder parts of the body, like the paws, tail, and face, that develop the darker color. This is Sadmouth Sam. She used to live here in our colony. She had this inflammation on her mouth, and inflammation is warm, so her face stayed pretty pale. As she healed and that inflammation gradually decreased, her face cooled down and got much toastier. Now that she's healthy, she has a pretty dark face. A lot of people have asked if Sad Boy gets along with the other cats here, or if he recognizes any of the cats who are related to him. The answer to both questions is not really. Obviously, Sad Boy gets along with the love of his life, Lola, but he mostly keeps his distance from the other cats. He's not aggressive at all. He won't fight them. But if another cat comes up to him, he'll usually just back off. The only exception is Georgie, because everyone loves Georgie. and sometimes Christian Dior. For some reason, Sad Boy doesn't seem to mind Christian Dior. Most of the cats seem to recognize Sad Boy as their elder, and they pretty much leave him alone. The only exception to that is Francois, who likes to walk right up and slap Sad Boy in the face. Before he was neutered, Sad Boy was definitely a fighter, but at this point, he's just a peaceful old guy who wants his alone time. This comment nailed it. When Francois runs up to Sad Boy and slaps him in the face, he's not trying to start a fight or be mean, he's just really stupid. Francois has nothing going on in his brain, and he interacts with his environment by running into things and hitting things and just seeing what happens. He'll walk up to Monkey and punch her in the face and then look around all confused like he's not sure how it happened. Francois doesn't have a mean or aggressive bone in his body. He is simply an idiot. Here's some Francois for you. What's he thinking about? Nothing. He's actually never had a thought in his entire life.
And every time it rains, and it's from heaven.
Shooby dooby.
Don't you know each cloud contains banners from heaven?
Shooby dooby.
You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is up, upside down. And trading for a package of sunshine and ravioli.
Macaroni!
If you want the things you love, you must have a pizzaoli.
This is MK. She's one of the feral cats who lives in the colony outside my house. When I first met MK, she was completely unsocialized to humans. I couldn't get within 30 feet of her. She spent all her time on top of our neighbor's roof, just hissing down at me. She had this high-pitched stress scream, and she would just hiss and scream for hours. It's been about a year now that I've been caring for MK, and I still can't pet her. I can't touch her at all. She's still terrified of everything. But she's discovered these lickable churu treats, and she loves them so much that she's gotten pretty brave, and she lets me feed them to her. So every day I sit outside with MK, and I watch her adorable little goblin face eat her treats.
We've been trying to get this car fixed for weeks, but the mechanic keeps falling asleep on the job.
As requested, here's more on the drama between feral cats Lola and MK. Their rivalry really just comes down to the fact that Lola's only desire in life is to be left alone. And MK is a sneaky little gremlin who likes to march right into Lola's territory and fall asleep in her bed. Lola actually hates all other cats, with the obvious exception of Sad Boy. And if a cat gets anywhere near her, she lets out this high-pitched stress scream. If any other cat hears that, they just back off right away. But for some reason, when MK hears it, she just screams back. She stands her ground and they just scream at each other. So we occasionally have to break up standoffs between Lola and MK. MK also hates Trader Joe, but that one's not her fault. He likes to bully her. And here's MK trying to start something with Francois, except he just does not care.
This is Sad Mouth Sam. She was a stray cat living in an outdoor colony that I inherited when I moved into a new house. This is the first picture I ever took of her. And once she started coming closer, the pictures just got more and more ridiculous. We weren't sure what was going on with her weird mouth. But once we knew she was friendly, we figured, let's get her off the streets. So we found a temporary foster who was willing to take in Sad Mouth Sam, and she also happened to be a vet tech. We learned that Sammy had something called eosinophilic granuloma complex, and she got treatment and started looking better pretty quickly. Sammy settled right into indoor life, and then something even crazier happened. We found someone who was willing to fly across the country to adopt Sam. So Sam met her new human, and it was love at first sight. Sammy packed up her bags. She spent a night at a Motel 6 in Phoenix, Arizona, and she flew across the country. She did a great job on her flight and made a lot of new friends. Now she's settled into her new home, and she is more spoiled than you could possibly imagine. She even has her own tiny room. Now she's a beautiful, healthy supermodel cat who still sometimes looks like this. This is Mr. Business. He was a stray cat living in an outdoor colony that I inherited when I moved into a new house. Don't tell the other cats, but Mr. Business was one of my favorites right away. He was super sweet and playful, and every time I went outside, he would come running to me and flop over for belly rubs. He didn't seem to mind living outdoors, but it wasn't safe for him. He really liked to walk right into the middle of the street and just sit there as cars drove by. We applied to get him into a local cat sanctuary. We called it his business school application, but he didn't get in. So we found a temporary foster for him, and we moved him indoors. We called his room the business suite, and we set him up with everything a spoiled cat could possibly need. He even helped assemble some of his new stuff. Mr. B loved being indoors and all the extra attention he was getting. Plus, we got him a professional new wardrobe for his adoption headshots. Mr. B found his new family pretty quickly. Now he has a cat brother named Taco and a dog sister named Ginger. I'm not sure what's going on here, but they all seem to like each other. Most importantly, Mr. Business has a boy now. They do everything together. They eat breakfast. They take naps. Mr. B even helps with homework. So helpful. And that's how a cat named Mr. Business went from being a skinny street cat to the CCO. That stands for Chief Cuddle Officer. You all know Monster Paws now, but a lot of you asked if he's fathered kittens. The answer is yes, definitely. He was just neutered recently at 8 years old, so he has 8 years worth of offspring. That's literally thousands of cats. So I thought I'd introduce you to one of them. This is Kangaroo. His mom was a stray who gave birth under our neighbor's shed. This is the night we found him. He's probably about 10 days old here. Very tiny, but his eyes have already started to open. He has three other littermates named Luke, Dumbo, and Party Time. Definitely looks like a mini Monster Paws here. We scooped up the whole family and got them safely indoors with a foster so they wouldn't have to grow up on the streets. Their mom's name is Tiger Lily. She was only about 6 months old and really malnourished when she gave birth. That's one of the reasons we spay and neuter cats. Here's Roo taking his first selfie. And here he is trying to drink from a water fountain for the first time. It was confusing for him. The whole family got vet care and all the toys and treats and playtime that they wanted. Plus, they were socialized to be used to humans instead of growing up feral. Eventually, they all got adopted. Here's Kangaroo meeting his new older brother. It was not quite love at first sight for them. But now Kangaroo is living his best indoor life with none of the hardships that his dad Monster Paws had to go through. Lots of you have asked about Trader Joe and Zippy. This one is Trader Joe. This one is Zippy. And for a very long time, I thought they were the same cat. I only ever saw one of them at a time, and I thought there was only one of them. When we moved in here and inherited this colony, I kept a running list of all the cats, trying to figure out how many there were total. And for months, that list said one gray and white cat. There were actually three of them, which is a whole other story. They are almost identical. They have this exact same pattern on their bodies, but Trader Joe has a lot more white in his face. They are brother and sister, but they're not usually together that much. Zippy is a lot shyer, while Trader Joe comes over more often, lets me pet him. They're also not ear-tipped. Most of our cats have that notch in their left ear, showing that they've been spayed and neutered.
TJ and Zippy are both fixed, but they were fixed at a regular vet and they just didn't get the ear tip. Some of you have asked if Trader Joe was named because he was found at a Trader Joe's. The answer is no. He just kind of looks like a little grocery boy. There's TJ sneaking up behind our pal Sad Boy. And there's Zippy with Sad Boy. Sad Boy looks awful there. That's a very old clip. Trader Joe was also the face of our holiday card. I have a fun fact for you. When male cats aren't neutered for a long time, they get these big puffy cheeks. These aren't my pictures. I just Googled tomcat cheeks to show you some examples. The cheeks come from all the excess testosterone, and they develop to protect cats' faces and necks, vulnerable areas, when cats fight. That's what male cats do when they're not neutered. They fight quite a bit. Most of these cats also look pretty beat up, and that's why. The cheeks are adorable. You just want to squeeze them. But as someone who does a lot of cat rescue work, I hate to see these cheeks. When we see a cat who looks like this, it means they've spent their entire lives fighting other cats and fathering a billion kittens. And most of those kittens are born on the streets into tough lives. People often ask why our feral cat Sad Boy is so saggy looking, and this is why. This is what he looked like before he was neutered. I don't have a lot of pictures from that time, but he had the cheeks. Sad Boy is an old guy and he went a long time without being neutered. Once he was neutered, those cheeks deflated. Now he's just got big saggy jowls. Plus, he's officially retired from fighting. How did I end up caring for a colony of stray and feral cats? The answer is accidentally. I moved into a new house and I didn't know that it came with 30 cats living outside. A lot of people have commented things like, "Oh my God, that sounds like heaven, you're so lucky." But I gotta tell you, it was not heaven at first. Every single one of these cats was sick, skinny, injured, pregnant, and/or giving birth in the middle of my driveway. They all had upper respiratory infections, they all had ear mites, they all had worms. We had one with a broken jaw who was slowly starving to death because he couldn't eat. We had another who ended up losing an eye. We started with about 30 cats here, and the colony is much smaller now. Partly because we've adopted out the friendly cats once they were healthy, but also because we lost some in that early period when it was just out of control. I had no background in animal rescue, and I had no plans to do any of this. Now it's less than a year later, and our colony is stable and healthy, everyone is fixed. We've ended up forming a team that started doing this work all over town. We've gotten tons of cats and kittens off the streets, we've TNR'd over 150 cats, and we've built up this cool community of supporters online. Thanks for being part of it.
You all know Lola as Sad Boy's very loyal life partner, but I wanted to tell you more about Lola's story. Because there was a time when we didn't know they were bonded, and Lola wasn't even Lola yet. The first time I saw her, she had kittens with her, and she looked like just a kitten herself. She was emaciated and exhausted. I didn't even give her a real name right away. She just automatically became Mama Cat. As Mama Cat, she was always scared and always hungry. Her kittens didn't survive. She started sneaking over every day for food, always with her ears pinned back, just eating as much as she possibly could while absolutely terrified. She was living in this constant state of fear and stress and starvation. We had to get her spayed before she got pregnant again. So we trapped her, and at the vet we learned that she was only about 8 months old. Since she was so young, there was hope that she could still be socialized to live as an indoor cat, and we had a foster who was experienced with socializing cats and wanted to give it a try. Remember, we didn't know about Sad Boy at this point. So Mama Cat spent a while indoors, but she didn't do well. She became more and more stressed and withdrawn, stopped eating, and started to deteriorate. So we had to make the choice to bring her back here to her outdoor home. When she returned here, it was time for her to have a real name. That's when she became Lola. And as soon as she was released here, she ran right to Sad Boy. They've been inseparable ever since. Now we've got Lola as you know her, healthy, chunky, relaxed, and living her best life with her Sad Boy.